that there is something solving of something. Why that's a really good question you have to ask yourself. Why are we not expecting that everything is screwed up? That we should expect everything is screwed up. What can be wrong goes wrong. What's it called? Murphy Law. Must be an Irish guy. Right? So, whatever goes wrong, yes. Yeah, but we don't. In fact, we live like everything will be very much fine. That's how we live. And otherwise, we cannot. Because if you start thinking what can happen, you go out of this door, what might be behind it, you know, what evil Swiss guy with his gun will stay there. You know, you will sit here until the ambulance is coming and gets you in the asylum. So there is no way. If you don't trust that everything works out fine, and you trust in a way, in a subconscious way, not thinking about it, because you start thinking about it, there are evils with people. They have guns, most of them. They don't like us here. So we can make a good case of not going out there, or at least not unprotected, or in the night, or whatever. So, no, we have this, and I think totally rightfully, I always think it has to do with our baby experience. But Donna Haraway said to me, don't romanticize babyhood, Wolfgang. No? Because there are some evil babies out there. They have a hard time terrorized. I was a very nice baby. Because when I was born, my father just was killed, my mother was about to kill herself. And so I had a very, very good intuition to be very nice and smile all the time, otherwise I would not survive this, you know. So, see, so that was the first thing, and so my mother always said, I saved her life, and probably mine too. So I would say, that was not a good idea to save your life, you know, you should have killed yourself, because life is not worth living. Yeah. But he could say this, because he was financially independent from his father. Anyway, synthesis attracts us. So we have an expectation, we have an intuition, there might be something. So the contradiction might not be the last word. And I'm totally with you that at the end you don't want actually to write a dissertation or a master thesis with an open question at the end. It is totally okay in our program. Also, we don't expect you to have a positive result, or that is one of the things which is also different. You know, as long as your deliberation is sophisticated enough. But all of us, we want to have a kind of solution, as temporary as it is, as we know of. Because we rightfully think we want to get at least a glimpse of how life fulfills itself all the time behind our back. How do we do that? And that is something, because in a business thinking, right, you would say, okay, it's like a negotiation, you know, you want to pay this, I want to have this, so let's see how we can find common ground, you know, to give and take, and then you make a kind of synthesis by bringing both sides together, but not here. This would be the coward's way out. Right? You are not taking the contradiction seriously. You say, no, if anybody is a little bit nice, etc., then can we not all get along? So something else is a coward's way. No, we don't want to get along, so we want to do the right thing. We want to find out how can we really, by appreciating both sides, finding something in which both sides have lost their power to determine our action or thinking. And this is people who will be still with us in 2 years in New York. I will teach this at the New School. Hegel is called the famous second negation. Second negation. This is between thesis and antithesis. That's the first negation. And the second negation. And this is still, I must tell you, this interesting part of it, is still a kind of secret. And I've been to many Hegel conferences and get my Moscow. I gave once a talk called Step or Jump. Methodological problems of Hegel's dialectics. Step or jump. My main argument was, when you jump, both of your feet are off the ground. So that means this is second negation. Within this is just the first negation, it's just a step. You go from one side to the other side in contradiction, but you are still in the same, field, you are still there, you are at the same ground. To leave this, you have to jump. And jump is, you know, it's the Kierkegaard's, the abyss, you jump into the abyss, what's called the leap of faith, right? The leap